Hey, hello, I'm Yolo. Welcome to the part 9. We have done a lot of things already, so let us continue. Today we will start working with eyebrows. As you may remember, we did eyebrows from a curve. That means we have an opportunity to make low poly from it. I'm duplicating them and reducing resolution as much as I can and converting it to a mesh. To do that, go to the object menu, choose convert and then mesh. I'm selecting every second loop and deleting it. By the way, I have made the whole video on the topic of selecting loops. I will leave a link for you in the description. I tried to make the model as low poly as possible, but at the same time keep the shape of the model. So the main thing here is to find a good compromise. I sink the back of the eyebrow into the head. It's not necessary to do this, but I usually do if the eyebrows don't match one-on-one with the vertices of the head. I'm turning on snap to faces and making sure that those vertices are located on the high poly surface. And closing holes. We've got our base low poly model. But to make it a bit better for animation, I'm moving edges to match the closest edge on the head. Adding a mirror modifier. Moving on, when I looked at her hair with a fresh look, it seemed to me too high poly, so let's remove some. By the way, after using merge once, I can press Shift plus R hotkey to speed up the process. It will repeat the last action you made. Once again, turning on snap to face and using move to distribute the vertices more evenly. And there are still too many polygons, I think. When I want to remove the edge, I also use this method. I press G hotkey twice and move the edge to the next one as close as possible. And if you have this option enabled, the vertices will automatically collapse when they are close enough to each other. And here I'm using the same technique. Right now I'm looking for broken polygons, those that are very bent. A game engine will triangulate my model on import, and doing so, it can choose any direction of the edge. So I'm adding support edges the way I like, to ensure that they will stay like this and not the other way, cause they can really break the model's silhouette. Okay, let's have a look at her hairband. I will copy a row of polygons from the hair to save some time, then moving it closer to the hairband and adding shrink wrap modifier. As a target, I will choose the high poly version of her hairband. And in this case, I'm also adding the displacement modifier to make the low poly model slightly higher above the surface. I like the result, so I apply both modifiers. Now it's time to move into the Topoflow plugin and draw the rest of the model. Adding symmetry modifier. I have to admit that I really enjoy using sculpting tools on my low poly models, thus expanding my arsenal of modeling tools. By the way, this is one of the reasons why I moved from ZBrush to Blender. And right now I'm using the Move tool to gently and non-destructively move the low poly model over her hair. Adding solidify modifier to add some thickness to the hairband. And once again using the Move tool. Yeah, it's really nice to be able to work like that. I'm working a bit in the opposite direction here. I want to make a beautiful low poly model first, and then I will adjust the high poly hairband model to fit it. I am fixing the high poly model. And moving low poly model slightly too. Okay, great! What do we have next? Let's work on the flowers. I'm moving into the Topoflow plugin and starting drawing polygons. The central part of the flower is round, so I don't even try to draw squares. I draw with triangles. With this approach, I will ensure that my low poly model will be really round. I try not to draw a lot of polygons, but nonetheless, I want to convey that nice round shape of the flower. Turning on snapping to faces and moving vertices around. Thank you. I'm continuing the same topology pattern through the other petals. Now we will move on to the back side of the flower. I might as well not do this side at all, but I want to be able to animate those flowers if I want to. So I decided to do very low poly backside. I'm selecting two edges and pressing F. And adding a mirror modifier. That's all, we are very close to completing the retopology, but we will need one more final part for the finishing touches. Thank you for watching and see you very soon. Bye bye!